You're back for more of His Dark Materials here on BuzzChomp, and I'm reacting to episode 3 of season 2. I'm Dan Salem. We've got one main hidden agenda, perhaps a few side ones, lots of secrets. The hidden agenda was revealed in this episode, primarily Lord Boreal's hidden agenda. We begin with Lyra sprinting off to World 2 on her own, Will's former world, to talk to the cave. Cave does speak, spoke back. She didn't get there because of the police, after her, after Will, and then Boreal swoops in. What's Lord Boreal up to, you might ask? Well, it appears as though he is good friends with Will's father. I'm kind of putting the pieces together. Will's father is the same man that Lee is after. Will's father calls to Lee, so it appears as though he's tapped into some witch powers. Will's father is tied directly back to the prophecy, a la Lord Boreal's agenda, the knife. I think it's safe to assume that, just like there are multiple alethiometers, although they are extremely rare, there are probably multiple knives, the slicers, the things that cut between the fabric of the worlds. We haven't actually seen one yet. We've just heard about them. We know that a slice exists between the two Oxfords. We don't know how it got there. Probably this knife. We could take a guess and say Will's dad used it to cross from where he previously lived to now where he does live in World 1. He doesn't actually live at Oxford, though. He's up in the hills pretending to be a shaman. It's interesting what Boreal is doing. The alethiometer is extremely powerful. He steals it from Lyra. He saves her, grabs her in his car, but he's buddy-buddy because he takes it from her, knowing that she will come back with Will. And he just reveals his hand perfectly. He's playing a game of poker. Everyone else is playing Go Fish, and they don't really know what's happening. This goes for Marissa, Lyra, Will, the Magisterium, Lee. Probably the exception is Will's father, especially since I'm guessing that Will's father and Boreal were buddies and worked together in the past. If Will's father has tapped into the witchy magic, then it's safe to say Lord Boreal has as well. And I'm wondering, because we got a glimpse of his home in World 2 at the end, he has a lot of stuff. How old is he? Does he age? What is he doing to preserve his life longer than is usually the fashion? Is it go back to the idea of a soul and an identity? He has a demon. Conveniently noticed, we haven't seen it in quite some time. We saw it all the time in Season 1. We haven't seen Boreal's demon at all in Season 2. He may be able to separate himself from his demon, just like the witches can, which means he has their abilities. And they seemingly live for vast amounts of time. I'm guessing he does the same. How could he have amassed that collection of things? Why would the alethiometer be of such lack of consequence to him if he doesn't already have those abilities? See, the alethiometer allows you to read the dust, read the particles of dark matter, and tap into the greater knowledge of the universe, of all the worlds tied to his one, right? You ask it a question, it knows the answer because it's tapped into the spiritual nature of everything interconnected. Well, the cave can do it. The alethiometers can do it. Probably the witches can do it too because they commune with dust. So if Lord Boreal has those abilities, then he's already doing that. The alethiometer is null and void. Also, he might not have the ability to read it. That is a special ability that Lyra has, supposedly. This is what we're told. We haven't really met anyone else that can read it. So it's currently unique, but is it? I don't know. So Boreal steals the alethiometer so that Lyra and Will go fetch the knife from the man in the bell tower of World 3, who probably... See, I thought that man in the bell tower was Will's dad, but then we're told Will's dad is in World 1 and Lee's after him and he's up in the hills. Can he be in more than one place at once? Is he actually in World 3, or is it a shell of himself, a la the specters stealing the souls of the adults? Boreal can't go get it in World 3, I'm assuming because the specters steal your soul. What is it about this bell tower? It's seemingly impenetrable. There's a random person up there. He has the knife, but he's not using the knife. Or is he? See, that's the funny thing. If the person in the bell tower has the knife, then it probably is Will's dad because he could just slice and step through between World 1 and World 3. Why is there only one sliver when you can create an infinite number of them? If you can make a sliver, there must be a way to stitch them back up. We haven't seen that tool yet. We haven't even seen the knife, just heard about it. The key here is to read between the lines, though. Why does he want the knife? He wanted to help Lyra to get the alethiometer so that she and Will would come to get it back so that he would then in turn get their help to go get the knife. Why does he want the knife? He is a genius little manipulator. He's manipulated Marissa. He's manipulating Lyra and Will. Will's dad, I think, is the trump. This is like two queens in a chess match going at it, right? He wants the knife for a specific reason. That is not his end game. He claims he is a collector. But there's something greater going on here. And we don't yet know. We only know his like intermediate goal, in my opinion. Tied back into Boreal's manipulation is Marissa, because Boreal's dropping her notes. I have your daughter. I know where she is. And she saves Lee, basically, because Lee got caught by the Magisterium. Then she swoops in and sets him free, because they each had a troubled past. But more importantly, Lee wants to protect Lyra with his life, so she wants anyone out into the world that's going to go and try to save her daughter, because apparently that's her mission now. Marissa flip-flops between evil deeds and positive mojo like no other, and I'm not convinced that there is truly, like, I said altruistic last video. I don't think that her motives are inherently good. They have good intentions. What does she really want, though? Because Lee said it. You love her, but you'd still hurt her. You'd still hurt and destroy her world. You don't want her to fulfill the prophecy because you know it means her death. So she probably wants to tell Lyra about it so that it destroys the prophecy, saves Lyra, and inherently destroys the entire world. Because she has no problem killing for the ones she loves. I was tipped off that this is not necessarily a purely scientific show, but more of a spiritual show. And spirituality and science go hand in hand, because anything we don't understand is spiritual. And then when we try to understand it, it becomes science. But it's like magic. It's all magic, right? Because you can't actually see it. And that's what's fun about this show so far. We are getting a glimpse of two different worlds, too. World 1, where we started with Lyra, is a more magical, spiritual world. World 2, with Will, is a more physical, scientific world. It's as much like ours if it's not inherently supposed to be ours. Boreal lives in both. He may live in another. We don't know. But there's only three, and he can't seemingly go there because of the specters, apparently. I think that there's like a war going on between Will's dad and Boreal. Now, this is my prediction. I think they both have witchy powers. I think they both know how to communicate and control dust. They obviously have active slivers. Will's dad's in the bell tower with the knife trash in between, hiding out from Boreal because he doesn't want Boreal to come steal the knife. And he's released the specters in the city to keep Boreal away because Boreal can't cross through the one sliver if the specters are going to get him. So it's almost like a defense mechanism. And even if he's not specifically defending from Boreal, he is defending from those adults that wish to tell him and get him harm. How else can he prevent them from stealing this all-powerful knife, specters that steal your soul? And it ties back to the demons, because I would think that the people from Lyra's world would be the ones really coming for the knife, as opposed to the people from Will's world, which don't even tap into that magical spiritual nature yet. I'm trying not to fall too far down the rabbit hole. I haven't read the books, so my mind is racing. I'm really enjoying His Dark Materials. I'm Dan Salem. Comment below with your thoughts on Boreal's hidden agenda. What's Marissa's true motivation? Is Lyra going to get tipped off to the prophecy and then actually still fulfill it? Or her and Will going to fall in love? Subscribe to BuzzChomp for more His Dark Materials all season long.